Thank you, Loupedeck, for sponsoring this video. So if you've been streaming for a while, or you just started streaming, everything that comes along that you have to manage when you're streaming can be a bit challenging. From changing scenes, to adjusting your settings, to adjusting your mic, to adjusting music, and everything in between, while also focusing on the game and the actual chat. Now, 100%, you can go ahead and go into Streamlabs and set up some hotkeys to be able to go ahead and switch between scenes by programming one of your keys on your keyboard. However, remembering what key does what is extremely challenging. This is why I utilize the Loupedeck Live S to be able to manage everything on my stream. Now, I'll go ahead and put a link in the description of this video if you want to learn more about the Loupedeck Live S, as well as a discount that will come along if you decide to go ahead and purchase it. So let's go ahead and talk about everything you're going to get on the Loupedeck. Then I'll show you how you can utilize it with Streamlabs, and I'll show you some other things that I use it for as well to make my life easier when it comes to working at my setup. So the first thing you're going to notice is that you're going to have these two dials on the left-hand side. Now, everything that you see here on the Loupedeck Live S, you're going to be able to go ahead and program. So these have these dials, these position dials that allows you'll hear the click every time you turn, allowing you to be able to go 85, 86, 87, exactly how you want it to be. You can also push down on them. This is going to be great to be able to mute, unmute, really quick feature there. And then the same thing goes for this one. You have the option to adjust these to anything that you want. So one can be for your desktop audio. The other one can be for your actual mic. And then here is you had four RGB buttons as well that you can go ahead and program to anything that you would like. And I'm going to show you here in just a minute, once you get into the software, all the features that you have available. But then you have 15 haptic feedback buttons here that when you push them, you can feel a slight vibration. And this is gonna go ahead and do everything that you want it to do. Now, you have 15 buttons on one screen. However, there's 14 pages that you're able to go ahead and go through, meaning you actually have 210 buttons to be able to utilize. Now, I've never been able to fill them all up. You may be able to, but however, I really love the way this is gonna be functioning here. So once you go ahead and get this plugged in, it's 100% plug and play, gets picked up right away by your computer. And then you're able to go ahead and get the actual software. So once you have it plugged in, you're going to come to the Loupedeck website and you're going to be able to go ahead and download the version for Mac or the version for Windows. Once you go ahead and download it, it's going to bring you to a dashboard just like this. This is going to be the software that you will utilize to be able to customize this to your liking. Now, the beautiful thing is that the Loupedeck Live S software comes with multiple profiles already built in. So if you're utilizing this for Streamlabs, it has a Streamlabs desktop plugin that I'm going to show you here in just a few moments, but it has other like Premiere Pro, Illustrator, Lightroom, OBS. You can create your own profiles if you want for different softwares that you're going to utilize. This makes it super easy. And having dynamic mode on, what it means is that the Loupedeck Live S is smart enough to be able to know what software you're in, and it'll automatically switch your profile directly on the Loupedeck for you to be able to start utilizing it. So what we're gonna do here is let's go ahead and open up our Streamlabs, because I really want to show you how you can go ahead and start utilizing this. Now, if you're looking and interested in the overlays you see me utilizing on Streamlabs right now, I'll put a link in the description of this video to streamdesigns.com. And if you've never used a Streamlabs before, I'll also put some videos down below to teach you how to utilize the software as well. So you're gonna see here that I have my starting soon, my countdown, my just chatting, my gameplay, my be right back, and my stream ending. And then I have my desktop audio and my mic. So when I come back here to the actual software, you're gonna see here that you're gonna have the Streamlabs desktop. You're gonna see it's gonna automatically pull in the scenes that I just went ahead and talked about, any of the sources that I went ahead and talked about, and any of the audio that I also went ahead and included there as well. And now what we're able to do is to go ahead and start creating these actual scenes. Now, by default, it's gonna already go ahead and create a scene like this here for you, minus a few additional things. However, to create a new page, all you have to do is hit this little plus icon. And remember, I mentioned you have 14 pages to be able to customize. So I just wanna go ahead and show you from the get-go how you can actually start utilizing this. So I'm gonna grab my scenes and I'm gonna go ahead and bring in my countdown, and it's just drag and drop. Everything that you wanna manage, you just drag and drop it directly where you want it to be. I'm gonna plug in my gameplay. I'm gonna plug in my just chatting. And then I'm gonna also do my starting soon. So now I have that in place there. Now I can go ahead and adjust my audio. I can do desktop audio. Now remember, I told you on these dials here, you're going to be able to put in whatever it is that you want. So this can be your audio to adjust the volume. And this is what I recommend. This is how I utilize it. So my desktop audio goes first, and you'll see here that the turning is for the dial. So this is for me to adjust the actual volume. Now, for me to be able to mute it, all I want to do is to go ahead and grab my audio, grab the mute, and then just drag it here. And now when I push down, it's gonna go ahead and mute. And I'll do the same thing here. So let's go ahead and see what that actually looks like, right? So here we have my desktop audio. So I programmed it for the top one. So when I select it, you're gonna see here that it's gonna mute it. But I can also turn the knob and it's gonna go ahead and adjust the volume on that. Same thing here for my mic. All I have to do now is push a button on it. It's gonna mute it. And then I can go ahead and adjust it. And you can program this to be anything that you want. It can be your music. It can be anything that you have there. All right. So once you've gone ahead and set that up there, you're now going to be able to continue to change everything that you have here. So if we scroll down just a bit, you're going to see you're going to have additional tools here. You're going to be able to go ahead and hit record. You're going to be able to go ahead and select some buffer. You're going to be able to toggle your streaming, studio mode, and everything that you need to be able to utilize this. So I'm going to go to the scene that I've already went ahead and set up. So for you to be able to see how this actually looks, here's where I have all my scenes set up. So on my Streamlabs, you're going to see here that I have studio mode and I have my actual scene. So if you've never used studio mode before, all it means is that what you have here on the left-hand side is just a preview for you. And then what you see on the right side is what your viewers are seeing. So here on my Loupedeck, I have studio mode. So I can turn it on and I can turn it off. And I typically like to use studio mode because it allows me to key up another scene when I'm ready. So here on here, I have my starting soon. So let's say I'm gonna queue up my just chatting. This lets me see that this is the scene that's gonna come up before I transition. And then on the Loupedeck, I'm able to go ahead and hit transition. And that's gonna now bring that over here live for my viewers to be able to see. And these are all things that we set up directly inside of the Loupedeck for us to be able to go ahead and utilize. Now, this also integrates with other tools as well, just as OBS, just as Twitch. And I'm going to show you here that there's tons of other things you can actually do with this. So you can also go ahead and toggle on your recording or your streaming. So again, if we come back here and you look at the Loupedeck, I have my record button. So all I have to do is hit my record button and you're gonna see here that my Streamlabs is now gonna start recording. So again, you can see here how easy it is to start utilizing a device like this to start managing your stream because you don't have to think about it. You literally push a button and you're able to make those adjustments. And again, you can go ahead and customize these images here if you want to be able to go ahead and make it look the way that you want. So if you come here and you hit this little pencil icon, you can go ahead and upload your own image and create your own text. That way you can go ahead and use designs that are easily recognizable to you, making it easy for you to be able to remember. Now, when you come here to the left-hand side, you're gonna see here that I also have a page for Twitch. So you can go ahead and come here to Twitch and you're gonna see all of the options you have available. So I can easily create a clip just by pressing the clip. I can go ahead and slow down chat. I can go ahead and send a message to like, thank you for following. You can send custom messages. I can go ahead and run commercials. There's so much things you can do here. And again, this just makes it super easy. Imagine having to be gaming and then have to go to Twitch on the computer and have to like press follow, press slow mode, or go into Streamlabs and having to switch scenes when you can just continue to play and just press buttons on the Loupedeck to be able to make these kind of adjustments. Now, I want to show you here, right? Because this goes beyond just being able to stream. You're able to do just more than that. So let's say, for example, you see here, I have my Twitch, I have Facebook, I have X, I have YouTube. I can go ahead and program any one of these buttons to open up a website for me if I want to. So if I were to hit YouTube, it's gonna automatically go ahead and open up YouTube right away, right? So again, here, I'm gonna close it up. I'm gonna go to my first page. I'm gonna hit YouTube and you're gonna see here, it opens up YouTube for me. So again, it's simplifying what I need to do to be able to manage my workflow. Now here on the left-hand side, you're gonna see here, you have your desktop. So you can start opening up certain programs. You can open up certain windows. It just makes everything that you do easy to be able to manage. So you're gonna see here, I can go ahead and adjust the audio directly on my computer. So I don't need to come to this little bottom side and adjust the audio. All I can do is directly on the Loupedeck, come to my mic. I can go ahead and mute it. I can go ahead and make adjustments. I can adjust the volume if I want to. Just that simple. Now, here's the beautiful thing with the Loupedeck Live S is that it has a incredible marketplace, right? So when I come to the marketplace, you're gonna see here that we have tons of profiles you can go ahead and utilize. You have tons of plugins that we can go ahead and utilize. And this is going to give you access to tons of plugins and tools and things that you can go ahead and integrate directly into the Loupedeck to be able to make things easier. So this is just a powerhouse of a tool that allows you to be able to go ahead and not only manage your stream, but also manage everything that you do. I utilize the Loupedeck every single day when I'm recording, when I'm editing, when I'm making videos like this, when I'm streaming. It just simplifies it. And you'll see that once you go ahead and get your hands on one of these and you pick it up, you're going to never want to not use it because of all the customizations that you have. Now, one of the things that I like to do is I like to set up different profiles at the bottom of the Loupedeck. This makes it super easy for me to switch between them. So here's my streaming center, and then I go back. Here's my Twitch chat commands, and then I go back. So again, you have my sound and my music. You can add sound effects here, so it also acts like a soundboard. So let's say, for example, something happens in the game or you're doing something pretty crazy. You can go ahead and come to your sounds and be able to play them automatically with a button. It's literally incredible what you're able to do here with this. Now, one of the biggest things that I want you to think about when you're looking at this is the simplifications of being able to manage everything on your stream. So again, this is a tool and a device that I do not live without every single day. So again, I'll put a link in the description of this video for you to be able to learn more about the Loupedeck Live S. And again, if you use the link in the description, you'll also get a discount to be able to go ahead and purchase this. So if you want to be able to even go beyond this and truly level up your stream and want to get more people coming in to watch your stream, to support you, and to help you grow and become full-time, I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step-by-step on what you should do if you're streaming to less than 25 viewers. Click that video right there. I'll see you guys in the next video.